Hi, I'm Dr. E, Ellen Stofan, and Dr. Z, Dr. Thomas Zurbuchen, and I would like to answer some of your questions. We got a question, which I think you and I only have one answer to. It says, what should I study in the field of space science, and why should you study it? And you and I have different reasons, so I'm curious to hear yours.
So first of all, should you study space science? Absolutely. It's a great subject area, and there's many different ways you can get into it. I actually believe the two of us have a different degree. I is a PhD in astrophysics. There's others that I know that went through engineering and so forth. And for me, what's really interesting is as we build teams, you know, these resilient teams that make these missions happen, it takes many of us with different backgrounds coming in and study whatever it is that you're most excited about. For me, that was astrophysics, and I'm really glad I did that. I focused on the sun, but you studied something else, right?
Yeah, I studied planetary geology, and this question was one of the reasons I wore my Cassini-Huygens shirt today. I worked on the Cassini mission looking at one of Saturn's moons called Titan, and we had people who were geologists, people who studied the atmospheres. We had people who studied the rings of Saturn. We had people looking at the solar wind out in the vicinity. So you had all these people from all these different disciplines, and we were all space scientists and all working together to really try to understand Saturn and its crazy system of moons. So to me, it's the best field because it's fun. There's so much to figure out. And you know, with data coming in from new telescopes like James Webb, we're never going to be short of puzzles for people to be working on.
So I want to ask one more question. I'm really curious about the answer, and it's really about you personally. What obstacles did you encounter as a woman in your career as a scientist, as an administrator first at NASA, now at the Smithsonian, and especially as a little girl curious about science? How did you overcome it, and who helped you along the way?
Well, I look back to my own personal experience and say, well, why, how did I as a young girl get involved when so few girls did? One of the things I really think about the fact is I had parents who hugely supported me. I had teachers who hugely supported me. And it wasn't till later in my career where I encountered obstacles and a lot of men who clearly thought I really didn't belong in the room. I got called little girl after I'd had a child by someone who actually worked for me. I did eventually encounter that kind of treatment, but by the time I did, I was a lot further on in my career. So I really think about how can we better support kids who may not have that support network of teachers and parents? How do we, as the science community, really reach out to kids and say, you know, science is a great field? The other thing I really think about, and it's something I work on a lot at the Air and Space Museum, is when I was a kid, I looked for women role models. I looked for, oh, were there women out there in science doing cool things? And I'd find biographies of Marie Curie, and that was about it. And I loved reading stories about Mary Leakey discovering the origins of life off in Africa. So I really looked for those women role models, and they were so hard to find. So as we reimagine the National Air and Space Museum, as we're redoing all the galleries, I really think about whose stories are we telling? And are we telling stories so that every kid, no matter what they look like, when they come in the museum, they understand that people who look just like them have been here all along doing amazing things in science, in technology, because we have to broaden out our fields. We have to make everyone feel welcome, or else we're not tapping into the talent of all of our population.
Well, I really want to thank you for being a role model yourself. I remember introducing you to my daughter and, you know, kind of the director of the Smithsonian and, of course, most distinguished scientist. What a role model you have been, and thanks for that. You know, you persevered and pushed through. There's challenges ahead of us. And I really want to thank you for being just a role model for so many.
Thanks so much. This has been really fun. And I can't wait to do our next episode of Easy Science.